Hey guys, today I want to introduce you a very high cost effective Otdr to you. And this is a model. It is FHO3000L. It has two wavelengths, 1310 and 1550. And it has 5-inch touchscreen. It is a capacitive touchscreen. Okay, now let me open it. This is a black bag. And what is inside? Let me check. Okay, this is the 3000L OTDR. It's the main unit. And the next one is the accessories inside. The accessories is including the, let me check. This is a quick guide for the mini OTDR. And the next one is the stripe for the mini OTDR. And the next one is the power cable and the data cable. This is a Type-C cable for power charging and the data transfer. And the next one is the SC adapter. And the FC adapter is installed already. And the next one is the power adapter, and the next one is the remote module for the Rj45 cable test, remote module. Okay, and this is the main character. This is the 3000L OTDR. Let me open it. Okay, we can see on the screen, there are multi functions. The first one is auto OTDR, an expert OTDR, and the event map, and the OPM function, and the VFU, data source, and the optical loss test, and the Rj45 sequence test, and the Rj45 lens test, and the Rj45 digital checker. And this checker function is optional, and the other functional is standard function. Okay, let me introduce first is about the interface. On the top, we can see here is the OPM function. And here is the flashlight. It is easy for work in the dark environment. And here is the VFU port. And here is the OTDR port and the data source port. And the next one is the two Rj45 cable test port. And on the right, we can see here is the TF card. It is the 8 GB memory card, and beside is the USB Type-C USB port for charging and for the data transfer. And the touchscreen is 5-inch. It is a capacitive touchscreen, so you can multi-touch. It's very easy to control it. And about the OTDR function, it supports auto OTDR and the export OTDR 2 modes. And this auto mode OTDR is for the inexperienced testers. There is no need for complex parameter settings. One key automatically to test the fiber link. Just this auto test to complete the test. And the test parameters and the test time. You just need to set these two parameters, no other settings. Okay, next I will show you the test of this auto OTDR test functions. And just insert the cable to the OTDR test port. And choose the test wavelength. Now we choose the 1550. And the test time, we choose 10 seconds or 15 seconds. And press the auto test. And wait for about 15 seconds, the test will be finished. And now it's fiber testing processing. The test is finished, and we can see on the top there are fiber trace, and on the below there are fiber events. This is the first start point, and in the middle, here is the connectors. because the test environment I can show you is two fiber spoons. This is the 25 kilometers, and the next one is also the 25 kilometers. And between them, here is the FC connectors. And we can see the test results. Here is the first segment, 25 kilogram kilometers, and the next one is the total length is about 50 kilometers. And here is the connector loss is about 0.26 dB. Okay, and we can see the total loss at the below is the about 9.78 dB. And this is the Otdr curve. Also, you can check the Otdr list. It's the Otdr list from the first one and to the last one event. And below is the event table. And here is the event map. Event map means you do not need to analyze the Otdr trace. You can check the Otdr icon. It will be more individuals. This is the start point, and here is a connector, and here is the last point connectors. And it can show you the pass and fail results according to your threshold setting before you test. And here, it provides a fast save button below. Then you can fast save the Otdr test. Okay, this is the first function of the Otdr test. No need complicated Otdr setting, just one click to complete the test. And next one is the expert Otdr test. This Otdr test mode is more professionals, because this mode you need to set the wavelengths and the pulse width and the test range and the test times. According to your test environment, you need to set these parameters by yourself. So according to the test environment is 50 kilometers, I set the test range to 64 kilometers, and the pulse width is 800 nanometers, nanoseconds. And also we can make the Avg test. Let me do it, Avg test. And we can see the marker B is automatically positioned to the fiber end point. And you can see it clearly at the fiber end. The fiber length is about 50 kilometers, and the total loss is about 9.35 dB. And this is the expert Otdr test mode. And the Otdr cursor is Otdr cursor, and the Otdr event map can be displayed directly in one test. Whether you are a tester expert or an inexperienced tester, you can easily analyze the Otdr fiber links. This is the first point, and this is the second point, and the third point. The event map is very clear. And next one is the event map. Event map is to test the fiber link by the icons. The test results will be more clear than the Otdr trace. When the fiber testing, please be avoid looking at the laser. It will be damaged to your eyes. Okay, the test results is like this. You can press each icon to check the detail about the event, each event, event. Maybe this is the event connector at the position to 25 kilometers, and the result is failed because maybe this connector is the loss is bigger than the threshold. And next one is maybe a fusion splicers, and the next is the last point. The fiber end. Okay, this is the three Otdr test: auto Otdr, expert Otdr, and the event map. And also, it has auto. It has a lot of other functions like the OPM, like the VFO, and the laser source, and the optical loss tester, and the Rj45 sequence test, and the Rj45 lens test, and the Rj45 digital tracker test. And this function is optional. And the OPM functions, let me check the wavelength. You can choose 1550, and the next one is 1490, and 1625, and 1650. And for multi-modifiable two, and 1380 nanometers, and 1310. A lot of choice for optical power meter test. And the test range is from the -50 to the +26. And I want to show you something about the power meter. Now I use another Otdr, the laser source. We use this laser source to display this OPM functions. Also, I tested this fiber spoon loss, and this is the OPM, and this is the laser source. Okay, let me turn on the laser source, and we choose the 1550 nanometers to open it. And here is the OPM interface. Okay, we can see the test results is about minus 19 dBm. Okay, next function I want to show you is the VFL function. VFL function is about 10 kilometer test range. It has two working modes. This is a normal mode, and then another one is the frequency mode, 1 Hz and the 2 Hz. Next is the laser source, and the laser source, it has two stable laser source wavelengths, 1550, and another one is the 1310. Let me open it, and we check the output power of this laser source. And we use this OPM function to check the okay, now I adjust the power wavelengths together and the 1310, and now here is the 1310 together, and I increase the power output power. Make it better, or you can. Yes, you can see the power is increased. And also you can change another wavelength, 1550. Okay, this is the laser source functions, and we close it. Next is the optical loss test. This means the OPM function and the laser source function can work together to check the fiber loss. It is a very convenient function for you. And here is also the Rj45 sequence functions. And here I prepare for a Rj45 cable and to test the Rj45 cable sequence. Usually we choose the this standard to test. We need a 45 cable, and another one is the remote module. This one, remote module. I connect the cable one side to the remote module and another one to the Otdr, this port. Test. And we can see the test results is the 8 lines strictly through. Means this cable can work normally. And another one is the cable length. Also, you can connect the cable with the module and this Otdr, and you can press test. It's in the testing process. Please wait. Okay, the result is this cable, the length is about 0.1 meters. And this Otdr have a very good function, is to move the cursor. I mean, because it is a 5-inch capacitive touchscreen, so if I want to move the cursor, it will be very convenient for this, like this. You can control the Otdr zoom in, zoom out by your hands. Zoom in and zoom out. And also you can move the cursor by your hands. Very, very smooth. Very, very smooth. And all the test files can be saved in the file management. You can see here all the test files is saved at the file management, and we can see the save settings, the file name and the file ID and the location and the direction and operators and the file naming type. All of these settings can be set in the save setting here. So this 3L mini Otdr is a multifunctional Otdr, which integrates auto Otdr and expert Otdr, event map, power meter, VFL, adjustable stable laser source, and optical loss test, Rj45 cable length sequence test, and the cable digital checker and the flashlight. It has 5-inch capacitive touchscreen and keys. It is the right assistant for optical cable constructions, installation and maintenance, and projector acceptance and on-site repair. Okay, thank you for your watching.